I'm Chris.
I'm Kristen, and welcome back to Keto in the Country.
So we think we figured out what you guys want most from a keto recipe.
We think that we figured it out, so we're going to go ahead and make it for you today. Don't go anywhere. So today we are going to be making a zero carb wrap.
Zero carbs. But first, I want to say something. And my youngest son told me not to say anything because nobody really cared. But we hit over 2,000 subscribers today. And we are so proud.
We are so proud. If you want to know the truth, we were excited to hit 100. I mean, that was our goal. We were like, okay, we just want to hit 100 and we'll be thrilled. But honestly, we are so excited to be sharing all of these recipes with you. We love finding people who are just as enthusiastic and passionate about the keto diet as we are.
And love to cook and want to keep it fresh and whole foods and healthy. So
exactly.
We're really excited. So thank you to our new subscribers.
Yes.
We will not let you down.
No.
Especially with this recipe.
This recipe today is awesome. I mean, what's so exciting, we have tried out other recipes that we do like, but the fact that this is so delicious and it's zero carbs, I want to be able to use my carbs on my veggies.
Zero carbs, and it's made from flaxseed. Flax has been around since ancient civilization.
Yes, it has.
So,
and flaxseed is so neat. I mean, there are so many fun facts about it. Dr. Axe points out that flaxseed is an incredible source of omega-3s.
Yeah, like 1500 milligrams
so
of
crazy.
omega-3, which is,
we love that,
and that's per tablespoon,
right?
It's 2 tablespoons in this recipe, right?
Yes, tablespoons per serving in this recipe. And we love omega-3s because omega-3s fight inflammation, which, if you've been listening to us, you know is very important to us.
And keto is designed to be an anti-inflammatory diet, so
right. I mean,
but we can't say enough about this flaxseed. So another thing I'd like to say before we get into the kitchen to cook them again is they travel super well. Once again, if you travel a lot, these will go with you anywhere. What else was I gonna say?
I mean, that's so nice because I know for us, like, I mean, when we're packing a lunch to go or when you go watch Adam's tennis games, I mean.
I took one, the other day and ate it in the car.
Yeah, it's just so easy. I mean, you can like literally just throw them in a bag. If you wanna keep them in the refrigerator, they keep really well too. I know for me, I love them. So I just like make a huge amount first. And the funny thing is you don't love coconut flour or almond flour.
I don't care for the taste of almond flour or coconut flour. So these are perfect for me.
Yes, they have such a mild taste and we're pretty sure that you're going to love them too.
It's also a great source of fiber, which makes it low in carbs.
Exactly.
So this is a superfood that's been around since ancient times, and we're just now figuring out how healthy it is.
And it promotes healthy digestion, which I know is something that everyone's concerned with. So, I mean, this is a great wrap. It is so sturdy. The sturdiest one that we've found.
The sturdiest wrap, and we'll show you how sturdy when we come back from the recipe.
We're going to go ahead and make it, and we'll be right back.
So there you have it. 3 ingredients for a zero carb flatbread.
Flaxseed, psyllium husk, water, and of course salt, but season it to your liking.
Yeah, we tend to get a little salty. And about the taste of flax, sometimes it's an acquired taste, sometimes yes. It's not. You liked it right away.
I thought that it had a very earthy taste right away. Mm-hmm.
We've tweaked it until it's so mild, and especially when you load it down.
With healthy veggies, put cream cheese on it if you want. Mm-hmm. I mean, I think you made it with an herb cream cheese, and that totally masked the taste of the flax.
God, that was so good. I couldn't even taste the flax at all. And it's just like that.
They're so durable. I mean, you can see I can stretch it as much as I want. Things might fall out, but the thing is not ripping.
Don't overstuff it.
Yeah.
Not because it won't tear, but because things will fall out.
Right. But we totally suggest this one. We know that this is a fail-safe recipe, and we hope that you'll try it.
You cannot mess this one up.
You can't. I like to put a little bit of butter in the pan. Some people suggest just doing it in a nonstick. Do it in a nonstick. I add butter for the fat and the flavor, and it's delicious. So let us know if you like it, and thank you for joining. As always, like and subscribe to our channel.
And thank you to the new subscribers.
Thank you so much.
See you next time.
Bye. So much thought into one little phrase, and this is like usually our
easy. When did it get so hard? I'm Chris.
I'm Kristen, and welcome back to Keto in the Country.
We've really been trying to figure out what you guys want in a good keto recipe.
Recipe, in a keto recipe.
I'm Chris.
I'm Kristen, and welcome back to Keto in the Country.
Oh.
I know, that was the part I was going to fool you with. I know, I'm going to take this out, but he was saying that I can't remember. So we're going to after I made. Yeah, thank God. Okay, so I'll just start this part.